Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 17.5 to the public. iOS 17.5 is out around the world at the same time for everyone on all iOS 17 supported devices, with new features, changes, and updates. Now as far as the overall size, well this will vary greatly depending on which version you're installing from, but it could be anywhere from about a gigabyte or so, all the way up to 6.51 gigabytes, depending on the version you're installing from. If it is 6.51 gigabytes, it's just reinstalling everything. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 17.5, watchOS 10.5, along with other updates that you can see here. So lots of different updates today, and of course you can update all of your devices at the same time. Now we do have a new modem update with this update, so that should help with overall connectivity if you're coming from iOS 17.4.1 or older. And as far as new features, changes, and updates, well the first thing has to do with Apple News. If we go over to Apple News, and if we go under the following tab, you'll see at the top we have puzzles, and we have an all new puzzle here called Quartiles. So if you want to play this, you can play it, and you can also see leaderboards. In the upper right with the menu, we have rankings, so you can view rankings or leaderboards playing against friends or family, and you also have an option to disable this if you want to as far as Game Center goes. If we go back to our settings, within settings, if we scroll down to News, Find News, and once you're in News, you'll see you have a new option for News Plus Puzzles. We can turn off Game Center or turn it on, but you'll see it says send your results to Game Center to see how you rank among friends and other solvers on today's puzzles. We also have a new News Plus Offline mode. Right above the News Plus Puzzles or Game Center update, you'll see News Plus Offline mode where you can have automatic downloads. You have some download options for things such as recent stories, saved stories, magazine issues, puzzles, audio stories, and then you can optimize your storage as well. So some nice updates there where you can just automatically download the content that you look at regularly. We also have a new wallpaper in this update. So if we go to our wallpapers here, press and hold. Within wallpaper, if we scroll down, you'll see new Pride wallpapers. You'll see there's a few different variants of this, and if we go into one, they actually have a really nice animation that's a little bit different. So we'll just go ahead and add that so I can show you. Hit done. Go to this wallpaper, and if we scroll home, you'll see a nice animation. It changes every single time. So again, if we scroll back, swipe up, sort of changes around. I would love to see this added to many more wallpaper. These animations are really nice, and again, I'd like to see them added to many different wallpapers as well. It's similar to live wallpapers we just haven't seen for a while. Another feature that's great if you're in the European Union is developers can now let you install apps from websites and not just third-party app stores. So they can opt to do that where you could install it via Safari or something else and install it directly on your iPhone. It does have to be checked with Apple, and that should help with overall security, but that's available only in the European Union. iPadOS is also seen as a gatekeeper operating system now, which means it will gain sideloading in the near future. However, it doesn't appear to be in this update just yet, so that's something coming very soon in the European Union. Now, if we go over to Find My, there's a change there that they've added. Within devices, you may have already noticed there's a new symbol here. If I go and maybe delete a device or try and delete it, there's a new repair mode where it says cannot remove iPhone, prepare this device for repair, and it says this iPhone is linked to your Apple ID and cannot be removed while it's online, but you can still prepare it for repair. After you've done this, you can continue to use it. However, it doesn't seem like there's any way to get out of this repair mode. Maybe Apple has to do it or reset it, or maybe they'll fix that in an upcoming update. But I just wanted to share that it is an option now where you can continue to use it, but put it in a repair mode so you don't have to fully wipe the device or remove it from Find My while it's being repaired. If we swipe over a couple pages, Apple has updated the podcast widget. If you'll see it here, we press play, it will now change to match the album artwork of the podcast that's playing. If we go in and maybe select a different one, select the Waveform podcast, swipe home, you'll see it's now red. So that's a nice little update, something we had in previous iOS 17.4 betas that they've now made live in iOS 17.5. Also to go along with podcasts, they've updated something here specifically in Spotlight Search. If we scroll down, go into our search and then type podcasts, it will now bring up the most recently played podcast. So it's just a nice little update, not a huge one, but at least it shows what you've been playing. And then if you want to go directly to those, you can start playing them if you'd like to. So it brings it down through the dynamic island. Again, a nice little touch for podcasts. So we'll go back in, close that out. And then we have an update for the weather widget. So you may have already noticed this. If we compare it to iOS 17.4.1, it's a small update, but they've changed some of the size. I actually prefer it on 17.4.1, but the actual temperature is a little bit smaller in the new update. So maybe they meant that on purpose, or they'll change it in the future. We also have an update in books. If we go into books, and maybe you have reading goals set, you now have an indicator similar to an activity monitor that we have for activities. So if we tap on this, you can see your reading goals here, and it'll measure your reading goals throughout the day and just show you at the top of the Books app. If we go into settings, within settings, if we scroll down and go to privacy and security, scroll down again, we have passkeys access for web browsers. Apple has now added an icon here where we didn't have one before. So it's a small update, but something they've changed in this update. Apple's also said that there's now cross-platform tracking. That means if you have a third-party tracker nearby, so whether that's an AirTag or maybe a third-party version, it will now alert you as to that being nearby you if you don't own it, just like it will with an AirTag or another device such as AirPods that are nearby that don't belong to you. So it's a nice little update just to include more devices that aren't necessarily Apple devices. If we go into messages, Apple has updated the behavior of emoji when you search for the word Jerusalem. So if you search for the city, there's no results there. Before, it showed a flag in different areas. Now it shows nothing when you're searching for that. Apple has added a new feature that they call a new Apple Universal Link for eSIM install. So there's a universal link listed here that should help developers add maybe eSIMs to their different apps, or just make it easier for maybe a carrier in their app to add it directly to your device. So they've added that option for developers. We probably won't see that at least right away. Maybe in the future, it'll just be a little bit easier to add an eSIM. We also have an update for the new Beats Pill that's being released. There's a new Beats Pill portable speaker, and there's a new animation for it that was shared by AaronP613 on X or Twitter. This is the animation in iOS 17.5, and if you have one of these new Beats Pill speakers, you'll see that once you connect it to the device. With iPadOS 17.5, Apple has added new code to allow for the new iPad Pro and iPad Air models, along with the brand new Apple Pencil Pro. So they've included all of that information so that those devices will work with iPadOS 17.5. There's updates with battery that they've included with this update, and in battery on the new iPad, iPad Air, and iPad Pro, we should see a cycle count or at least battery health. The code is there, but again, they haven't brought it to the current iPads. It looks like they're doing the same thing they did with iPhone 15 and iPhone 14, where the newest phones got the update to show us battery cycle count and more battery health information. It looks like we're gaining that on the iPad, but as soon as it's released, of course, I'll check that out for myself and share it with you. Now, all of the major features are being saved for iOS 18. Of course, that's coming on June, at least for the first betas, so we should see that with June 10th or so, right after the keynote, and then see all of the new features there. So don't expect any major updates until then. But we do have some bug fixes and release notes that I've talked about a little bit already with those new features, but the bug fixes specifically Apple hasn't said. So if we go back into photos here with the screenshot of the update, it just says that there's bug fixes and security updates. I wish they would give more details, but one bug fix, whether or not we know for sure, is we have an issue with the clock where the alarms don't work properly. Apple is aware of this. They said they'd resolve this in a future update. Hopefully it's resolved in this update. It hasn't been an issue for me for the past couple of versions as far as a beta tester. Hopefully it's resolved here. And if I hear officially from Apple, I'll be sure to share that with you. Within the notes, there's no known bugs that are listed, but we do have some issues such as the wallpaper dimming bug where it desaturates. It doesn't seem to happen all the time, and it looks like it's fixed on this wallpaper, but sometimes you'll set a wallpaper and it will still do it. Hopefully they fix that. We also still have the standby bug. If I bring in this Anker charger, place my phone on it, lock the phone, give it just a second, let it go into standby mode. Once we're in standby, we can swipe through our different clocks, and once we've edited it a single time, we can no longer edit again. So I can't edit this by pressing and holding. If you tap on it, there's no options. It just doesn't do anything. I've reported it in the feedback app. Hopefully we see this fixed very soon. But if it's working now for you, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Just like every other iOS update, Apple is including security updates with iOS 17.5. On Apple's security release website, though, typically they don't release the updates as far as what they've specifically fixed until well after the update's released to the public. So by the time you're watching this, it may already be live, and if it is, I'll link this in the description so you can check it out. But you can just go into the previous ones and see the different bug fixes, and there's always more hour to list. Sometimes they take days to list them. Sometimes it's right away. So hopefully that's updated very soon and they'll let us know. With battery and performance-wise, iOS 17.5 seems to give it a performance boost. Not just benchmark scores or anything like that, but just smoothness overall is very nice. It seems to be very smooth. They've fixed most of the micro stutters on pretty much every device, including the iPhone 11 that I have here. Swiping through, sort of scrolling. Of course, we don't have ProMotion here, but everything seems to be smooth and fast. Most people have reported this all throughout the beta, whether you're going into music in the library, swiping through. You may have a few hiccups or stutters here and there, but in general, it seems much faster than iOS 17.4.1. Now, heat on the device seems to be pretty good. Throughout the betas, it's been improving, at least for me, where it doesn't get that hot on the back. It's staying nice and cool. So I have no complaints here. I do hear from some people when charging, it seems to get hotter than normal, but it does warm up and that's typical while you're charging. But again, that really relies on a lot of different factors. Overall, I'd say it's doing much better that way with 17.5. Battery life, though, is a different story. Depending on who you ask, it's been really good, and for some others, it hasn't been great at all. For me in particular, it's been okay, but not great. If I go into the battery health, you'll see I'm down to 98% with 184 cycles, and if we take a look at the last 10 days, yesterday I had 2 hours and 30 minutes of screen active time, 3 hours and 28 minutes of screen idle time, and used about 75% of the battery, which isn't great. By the time I go to bed, I'll typically be down to about 20 or 30%. So I may have some issues going on here, but you'll see it's just the home and lock screen, music, maps I did use quite a bit, so maybe that's some of it, as that does use a lot of power, but nothing really out of the ordinary. It just seems to be a little bit worse than normal. So for me, I'm not sure why that is, but some people report it's far better than iOS 17.4.1. But now that it's out to the public, we'll have to give it a few days and see for sure. So I'll talk about that in the weekend follow-up video. If you're wondering if you should install iOS 17.5, well, it definitely seems better than iOS 17.4.1, with the exception maybe of battery life, but again, I don't know that for sure, as some people say it's great, some say it's not, so we need to give that a few days. As far as when to expect the next version, well, iOS 17.6 Beta 1 could be within a day or two, or could be the following week. That, of course, will be smaller updates, but we'll have those updates alongside iOS 18, where Apple will show iOS 18 Beta 1 or release it on the 10th, typically after their keynote at WWDC 2024. They'll release it to the beta testers or developers. Sometimes the public beta takes a couple weeks or versions, and then they'll release it to the public, typically in early September before the next iPhone launch. So that's where we'll see all of those major features, but iOS 17.6 should be probably this week or next to go along with that. And so that's pretty much everything in iOS 17.5 so far. There may be some small wording changes here and there. I've seen that throughout, but nothing major other than what I've mentioned already. Now, if you've found anything else that I haven't mentioned, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.